If there was a good news story, ever was a good news story, a great news story, this is it. We're just beginning to hear all of the phenomenal stories of fear and hope and courage. There are 156 survivors. Everyone on that plane lived. And we're hearing some of their stories tonight. We begin in Charlotte, North Carolina, with Vince Spera, one of the survivors, and Darren Beck, another survivor, and Don Norton, another survivor. There you see all three sitting. Vince, did you have any apprehension about flying down to Charlotte today?
Actually, I flew in yesterday. I was on the last plane out of LaGuardia, 10 p.m. flight. I landed here in Charlotte about a little bit after midnight last night, or this morning, I guess.
Was it U.S. Air?
U.S. Air, yes.
Darren, did you have any apprehension about flying?
Absolutely. I was very hesitant to get back on an airplane, but honestly, my desire to see my wife and three boys again overrode any fear I had of getting on that plane.
Did you fly down today?
I flew down last night also. I wanted to get home as soon as possible and hug my family.
And Don, what about you? Did you have any worries?
Yeah, I mean, it was definitely a little nerve-wracking last night when we flew back. I mean, especially as we were doing takeoff and landing. It was very anxious, but the same thing that Darren said, I was really anxious to get back to see my family, hug my 2.5-year-old son and my wife.
Darren, what was that like, hitting the water in a plane?
That was unlike anything I'd ever experienced. I can't say I've ever been in a plane crash before. I was more fearful that we were going to flip over or cartwheel or something. We did lift out of the water slightly, fortunately fell back down flat, and I was incredibly relieved.
And Darren, when you got in the life raft, you called home?
I did, yes. Probably not the best thing to do. I probably should have been trying to get on the ferry, but I didn't want my wife to see it on the news because I knew it would be all over. I could see the helicopters swirling already, and I called her and said, honey, I can't talk now. My plane crashed, but I'm fine. I don't know if that was a good thing or a bad thing, but
what did she
I just
say?
Wanted her to know from me. She said, what are you talking about? She thought, normally when I fly out of New York, the biggest concern, usually when I call her, that means the flight's delayed. That's a very common thing out of LaGuardia. But in this case, she probably wishes it was a delay instead of a plane crash.
Don, were you very scared?
When we hit the water, I mean, it was very jarring. I was in seat 11F. I was right by the emergency exit, right by the door. I jolted a little bit forward. It was terrifying at first, but then when I realized that the plane had come to a complete stop and we're still in one piece, I felt a lot of relief. And then I just went to open the emergency exit door as fast as I could.
Was it easy or hard to open?
It was easy to open and pull off, but then it was a little bit challenging to take it and put it back through the hole and into the water so people could get out. But I was able to maneuver it through and then throw it into the water and then step on the wing, and then everyone started streaming out of the plane.
How quick were the rescuers there?
They were there as soon as I was saw right outside of the plane. I mean, we saw ferries converging on us. I saw helicopters in the air. I mean, they were there in seconds. I mean, they were already on their way as soon as they saw us hit.
Vince, when you flew out last night, did the pilot or co-pilot make any reference to the crash?
The flight attendant did. We were on a CRJ, a smaller 2x2 plane. It was myself and about 8 or 9 others that were in the crash as well, plus the regular passengers on the plane. The flight attendant did make a big deal that we were on the plane, and by the end of the flight, I think the whole plane had pretty much bonded.
Darren, did you have to pay for the flight?
I was very fortunate, actually, in that the CEO of our company was on the phone with me constantly. Don and I work for the same company, and he was very concerned about us and another individual from our company that were on the plane. I wasn't sure exactly when we were going to get out or how we were going to get out, and he said, don't worry about anything. I'm gonna charter you a plane to get you back as soon as possible to be with your families.
That's great. Don, did you think when it started to bank and turn and there was the sound that you were heading to LaGuardia or to Teterboro?
I absolutely thought we were headed to LaGuardia at first, because when our engine, what I thought blew, the pilot kept it very, very steady, and it just felt like we're just going back to the airport. When he took another hard left, I knew that we weren't going back to LaGuardia, and that's when I started to see water, and I was like, okay, I guess we're going to the water.
With us from Charlotte, Vince Spera, Darren Beck, and Don Norton, and also joining us right behind her husband is Tara Beck and little Tyler Beck, the 10-year-old. All right, Tara, what was it like when you got that strange phone call?
It was kind of weird, actually, because I was just expecting my dad to come back from an ordinary business trip. And then when I got the phone call, it was just like, oh my gosh, is he okay? I'm scared. What'll happen to him?
What was it like for you, Tara?
It was really frightening. I was really glad he called me before I saw anything on the news. So I was really glad he was okay, but it was still a very nerve-wracking, frightening day watching it go down on TV.
After the call, did you turn on the TV right away?
Unfortunately, I was on my way out the door to pick up Tyler at school. It was real quick and he had to hang up. So I was panicked and I was calling my friends to have them figure out what was going on, but nobody was answering the phone. And I kind of thought he was probably on the runway. I usually don't get a phone call that, you know, we crash and we're okay.
No.
So I didn't think he made it very far. And then the next time he called, he said he was in the river. And that's when I really kind of panicked.
Tyler, I understand you gave your dad, did you give him, a medal?
Yeah, I made my mom promise to tell my dad to wake me up as soon as he got home, because I'm like, when you get home, you're going to get in and give me a hug. I don't care how late it is. So I gave him this little medal I won in a triathlon, and I'm like, this is your survivor medal.
So, what grade are you in?
I'm in fifth grade.
Well, Darren, you must be mighty proud.
Yeah, Larry, you can see why I was in such a hurry to get back.
Vince, how did your wife handle all this?
It was interesting, Larry. I was actually on the 5 o'clock flight originally, but I hopped an earlier one to get home early, so she was very excited that I was coming home early. Unfortunately, that didn't work out, and I didn't get home early. But once she got the news that I was okay, she actually saw me on television getting off the raft before I was able to speak with her, so things really worked out for the best, I guess, but it just took a little longer to get home than expected.
Don, what about your missus?
Actually, I had trouble getting a hold of my wife, and I finally got a hold of my mother-in-law, who was supposed to pick me up at the airport, and told her, I told her that, you know, I was in a crash, and she didn't believe me at first, and she said, do I still have to pick you up at 5? So she really didn't grasp what was happening, but she did end up texting my wife, and my wife called back on the phone I was using because both my phones were on the plane, and she called back, and my wife was in hysterics. She was already starting to suffer laryngitis at the time, so I couldn't understand a word she was saying. She was just crying and crying and crying, and then I told her, I said, I'm okay, don't worry, I'm okay, and then I wasn't able to call her back for quite a while, and she ended up getting in touch with Tara because she hadn't heard from me in a few hours. And she called her, you know, panicked, like, is everything okay? And then I ended up talking to her later on before we got in the air to come home.
Darren, is it true that the back door wouldn't open and that if it had opened, that might have sunk the plane? Is that true?
I honestly don't know. I was actually near the front of the plane, so I don't know what was going on in the back of the plane. I can't answer that.
We'll check with others. Vince, you think you're lucky?
Very lucky, Larry. And I spoke with a gentleman that was sitting in the back of the plane, and he confirmed that the back door would not open, and the back of the plane was indeed filling with water, getting waist deep and higher. So they had a bit more of a hard time in the back of the plane than I did in the center, or some folks did in the front.
Don, you feel lucky?
Unbelievably lucky. You know, thank God for the pilot. He did a spectacular job, and I think we all just, we owe him a huge debt of gratitude, and I think I owe him a big hug.
And Tyler, congratulations on the medal. You must feel pretty good about things.
Yeah, I guess I owe my dad something, so made me feel better.